Has a loved one ever passed away in a hospital's hands, leaving you with not only sadness, but frustration at the hospital's poor management? Has a patient's emergency appointment been delayed for seemingly ridiculous reasons? Hospitals generally rely on tedious modes of transport, such as phone calls, faxes, handwritten notes, and even whiteboards to schedule appointments and procedures. These could get lost, erased, or have careless mistakes. Severely delayed emergencies do not only result in annoyed patients and staff, but also may lead to death.
In 2009, when Julius Gold's dad had a heart attack, the hospital had a delayed reaction due to the slow procedures of
scheduling. My dad had an artery that was 100% blocked, and another that was 70% blocked. It was so lucky that he lived.
Her dad was taken by ambulance on Saturday, March 30th, 2009, to Shady Grove Hospital in Rockville, Maryland. He was at the intensive care unit for his entire stay other than the surgery.
I was at soccer practice when I first heard. I was so worried. There were so many things that could go wrong.
Luckily, nothing went wrong during the surgery, but there was plenty wrong with the hospital.
It was Saturday, and most of the people who worked with heart surgery weren't even there. Everyone had to be called in, and it felt like it took them forever to come.
During a heart attack, time is crucial, and wasting time is sometimes deadly. Luckily, the hospital managed to pull through, and Julie Skull's father was saved. After a week of recovery, he finally left the hospital. Julie's father was lucky. Some aren't so fortunate. An average of 195,000 people die in the USA per year due to potentially preventable in-hospital medical errors. Sometimes, human reactions are just too slow. Sometimes, we need the benefits of technology.
NASA discovered this issue at work as well. While managing the Hubble Space Telescope, engineers found multiple complications. Only two scientific instruments could be operated at a time, and changing the telescope's focus was painstakingly slow. It soon became clear that a new software had to be produced. Then, in 1985, Don Rosenthal, one of NASA's computer scientists, helped create a new scheduling and programming system, which improved the telescope's efficiency. He later acquired intellectual property rights to the software and used it in Ames Research Center on the Mars Exploration Rover, the Pioneer spacecraft, and spacecrafts for human travel. Rosenthal then co-founded Menlo Park, California's Allocated Incorporated, in 2004. The company released a software called OnQ that organized the constantly updating schedules of hospitals. This proved to be practical for use in space, but on Earth it was just as fast, easy, and effective. OnQ designates resources and manages disruptions for quicker, more accurate schedules and a safer hospital. Patients would get their treatments a few minutes sooner. Those minutes could save their lives. The California Medical Center, or CPMC, began to beta test OnQ in 2006. The results were spectacular. Procedure volume increased by 12%, and staff overtime decreased by a whopping 35%.
Think of Julie Skull's father. With technology like that, he might have been able to recover faster. The fumbled mistakes and slow reactions would not have occurred. OnQ would have immediately corrected the schedules with precision.
Imagine how the future of hospitals will be with this new breakthrough. The current bustling, stressful, and overall tense atmosphere of hospitals may be transformed to a more peaceful and tranquil environment. The staff will benefit from this, and so will the patients. Every day, many die untreated at hospitals. OnQ saves time. OnQ saves lives.